All right, everybody, it's that time. It's June 6th, but to be honest, for, I don't know, about a week now, this Goumi bush has been ripening its fruits. And I've been really enjoying, as I do every year, the fruits on this bush. This is the Carmine variety. I know a lot of you guys have seen, probably at this point, my videos on this particular variety. It's becoming quite popular. I'm not kidding. I get a lot of people who reach out to me and want plants of this. They want to know if I've propagated it. They want to know so much about this because I've clearly intrigued you guys. And you know what? You should be intrigued. This is truly an incredible piece of fruit. I love this thing. I'm out here for extended periods of time eating this. Very soon, I'm going to actually take off some fruits and I'm going to freeze them because I'm curious to see what happens when you freeze them. I wonder if the astringency, there is a slight level of astringency that does go away as they ripen. It's nothing like a persimmon, that's for sure, an astringent persimmon. It's kind of like a green banana level of astringency, but it does tail off and get less and less to where you almost don't really even detect it when the berries turn fully red. And then when they turn fully red, they'll start to dry on the tree, which is kind of why it's called Goumi, right? They kind of turn into gummy bears. The fruit is incredibly complexly tasting. And this is one realization I had this year where I just realized that this is like eating wine. Is the closest thing, the closest fruit that I've ever had, or the closest food I've ever had to actually drinking wine. And I'm not even, I think it's actually pretty darn close. This is like, if you had a really nice bottle of wine, and let's say you rated them from 0 to 100, and so a nice bottle of wine's like a 90 or a 91, 92, this is probably like an 84. I'm not kidding. And so what's nice, not only does this like give me wine vibes, because it coats your palate. I mean, that's really, I think, what the deal is. This fruit, when you eat it, after you eat it, you have a lasting impression way longer than any finish I've ever had in any wine. The finish lasts for like 5 to 10 minutes, maybe even longer. I actually just filmed a 25 minute long video, and I still have a little bit of that feeling in my mouth. From when I was eating the berries before filming the other video I just did. They have, again, it's very complex in that it's acidic, it's sour, it's sweet. They taste like fruit punch. There's a nice berry flavor to them. There's a little bit of astringency. So they're really nicely complex. And to me, I think they're fun to eat. My new thing now of something I like to do, I showed this to you guys before, where I'll hold it by the stem. And so then I'll put the berry in my mouth and I'll kind of eat around the pit. And then you're left with the pit. By the way, it's really just an incredible feeling in my mouth right now. Like I just drank some wine, but there's no alcohol in it. That's the other nice thing. But here's what I'll do now. What I've been enjoying is actually taking the pit and just chewing on it for a little bit. It kind of reminds me of like chewing on some sunflower seeds, the shells, but not dry. You know how some sunflower seeds, you get the salt off of them, and then there's just this dry shell left over? That's not what this is. It's similar texture, but there's apparently some oils and things in here. I don't know the science. I'm not a scientist, guys. You know, I'm not going to claim that I know all the health benefits of this crap, but apparently there's some pretty nice oils in the seed. That's what I've read. So I've just kind of made it a habit. And by the way, it's kind of fun. Like, I enjoy sitting here and then just chewing on it. Then I spit them out. And by the way, it's just like, again, it's just like an enjoyable experience that I feel like you guys ought to have. So I guess that's another thing going for this, I haven't been able to figure out again how to propagate this, but my I talked to Lucille Whitman at Whitman Farms. She's a nursery woman, and how she propagates her plants, which is, by the way, where this plant comes from. There's another variety called Tillamook, which she gave to One Green World, and I guess they renamed it, or what, I don't know how, I forget the story exactly, what she told me on the phone. But essentially, all the plants basically of this variety, Carmine or Tillamook, are all the same variety and originate from her. I don't remember where what she said where she got hers from, but the way she propagates it is that she actually takes the cuttings with the leaves on them during the growing season. So something like this would be really nice, this really vigorous water shoot here that is new growth of the season. You take this off after it's done fruiting, and then you just put them in rooting hormone and then root them under a misting setup. And that's basically your best bet. I do know that air layering works. I think the timing of that is not really clear to me. Rooting hormone suggested. And so I'm not going to give up because I love this plant. I want another one. Not only do you guys want one, and people keep asking me for them, if I have any, where to get one. I don't have any, but I hope to at some point in the future. And I also am really hoping to get a bunch of seed and try to germinate the seeds. I have to read up on that. People have actually commented and said that they're invasive, like the autumn olive, because that's what they're related to, this Goumi plant. But I have not seen any seeds come up, and I spit them all over the place. I've seen birds eat them, and I've just, you know, I've never seen one actually, you know, crap one out. But in general, I've never seen any seedlings pop up. That would be great. I would love that. And I would love to actually see if I could plant some seeds of this, grow out some seedlings, and see if we can get an even bigger fruit that maybe tastes just as good or maybe even better. That's the beauty of this variety, is that the other ones that you can find, sweet scarlet and red gem, they're just not, they're not really that large. In fact, this is like four times the size of the others, and the others are, they're almost just not worth eating. The flesh to pit ratio is just not there. And so for me, I don't really recommend them, but it'd be nice if you could grow it and get the same taste experience, but I'm just really not sure if you are gonna get the same experience that you would from Carmine. This right here, however, we just planted. This is a ruby autumn olive. And I got this from One Green World. I know that who sold me on this was Burnt Ridge Nursery, the guy at Burnt Ridge. I don't remember his name, excuse me, but he's got videos on YouTube as well that are very informative. I mean, my goodness, is that guy a wealth of information. And so he has a video on autumn olive, and I just was interested because obviously Goumi is related. But what's different about the autumn olive is, well, there's a lot of differences, but the most common or the most obvious one you might think of is that it ripens in autumn. I mean, it's called the autumn olive. It looks like an olive tree, and it ripens in the autumn. So the Goumi, though, is the total opposite. It's one of the first fruits to fruit. And so this will go from the end of May, beginning of June here in the Philadelphia area, till about July. The crop's actually ripening very quickly this year. I think we've had a lot of heat, and that's probably why. But this autumn olive, if I can have a Goumi that fruits in the fall, that would be awesome. Now, is this autumn olive gonna taste as good? I don't think so, but it would be nice to have this fruit at that time to maybe see if I can have some kind of replacement during that time of the year. So that's why we planted this here. They're both rather shade tolerant too. I don't have to really plant them in a lot of sun, as this plot here that I just created, we put down a lot of wood chips that we got a delivery from. I inoculated this with wine cap. We planted actually some catnip down here. I got a dwarf mulberry. This is an aronia. We have a American persimmon back there. And so this plot only gets 4 or 5 hours of light a day. and this autumn olive really should have no problem fruiting. What we'll be interested to see is the size of the seeds, the flavor of the plant, the flavor of the fruits, I should say, and then also, you know, other characteristics. But, you know, I'm looking forward to it. And so that's the story there. I went with Ruby, again, Ruby Autumn Olive and Carmine Goumi. We will see you guys for the next one, all right? Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button for me. Catch you guys for the next video. Take care.